What you guys got another video here for you. This one's probably another controversial video which will probably get a few people triggered, but I'm gonna do it anyway because I've been wanting to do this for a while and a lot of people always ask me, will Linux ever replace Windows or Windows 10? And the short answer to it is no. And I'm gonna give you my reasons why, because personally, now because of one user or home users will say that Linux is the best thing since sliced bread and you should ditch Windows, that doesn't make it the best operating system, or it doesn't make it the operating system for businesses or companies to use. You've got to look at the bigger picture. It's all the companies, the enterprises, the industries out there that are creating stuff for us to wear, to use in our homes, you know, to run our electricity, our water, all this sort of stuff. These people use Microsoft Windows, and they have done for many, many years. So why aren't they using Linux? Linux is a great operating system, but can it support the masses that Microsoft actually does on a daily basis? And I don't think they can. And it's the support part that's really, really important for companies. And for the home user, he's just a small little fish in a big pond, and that's the problem. People get that mistaken. Another big dependency for companies is software, and software has been used on Windows systems for many, many years. So for instance, a designing company would be using Adobe products like Adobe Photoshop or Illustrator. Can you imagine those companies now using programs like GIMP as a replacement? They would have to retrain everyone in their company to use Linux first, and then obviously support GIMP, and then start training them to use GIMP. And this would be an absolute phenomenal cost. It just would never work. And the misery doesn't end there. You would have to retrain all of your technical support staff to support the Linux of your choice, and also then support the software which you might be using, i.e. in this case might be GIMP instead of Photoshop. So the list goes on and on. It would be absolutely foolish to do that. And of course it doesn't stop there. You've got the multimedia side of things, which would be using, say for instance, Adobe After Effects and programs like that, maybe Maya 3D. You would then be using other programs like Blender, you know, in replace of that, because you might not be able to get those programs to work properly on the chosen distro or the chosen Linux version that you're using. So not only would you then have to retrain everyone to use Linux again, and also retrain everyone to use another piece of software like Blender, you would then have to train all the technical support staff to support that software and also that operating system. So it's a big steep learning curve, and that's probably why people will just stay with Microsoft Windows, because they've got the licensing in place for all the software, they've got the training in place for all the software, they've got the technical support, they've got the support from Microsoft. It just makes sense. And then you've got the manufacturing side, which is crucial to industries that are supplying us stuff that we use and in our homes and stuff like that, like AutoCAD, ESprint and things like that, which are designing software. And there is alternatives for Linux, but there's just massive training involved to retrain people to use that type of software. And again, you're running into the same old question of support and also technical support and things like that. So I don't see it changing anytime soon. And this is just mainly about business. And that's probably the bulk of the people that are using Microsoft Windows on a daily basis. So this is not about the home user at all, really. Like I said before, they're just a small fish in a big pond. Now you can use office suites as well, like this one here, instead of using the Microsoft Office versions. Or you could go online and use the online version, but it's just not the same as having software installed on the system. There's lots of companies that use Outlook and a bunch of other software from Microsoft. So there is a workaround, and that's what it seems to be with Linux all the time. It's like always a workaround. Using virtual boxes inside Linux, and you know, trying to get games to work by using certain steps to get them to work. It's always been the same until it's fully compatible. And some of this is not Linux's fault. It's software distribution companies that don't actually support Linux. They just won't put the money and investment into such a small piece of pie that Linux holds. So they're just not going to chuck out the support there and make their software available to Linux users, which is a bit unfortunate. Again, games have got a lot better over the years. You can see now you can play a lot of games on a Linux-based machine. Is it going to be better than Windows? You might see some people saying it is. It's not. There's loads of games that don't work, or you have to tweak or mess around them to get them working. Some of them have got a gold or platinum reward. Even this Metro Exodus, you have to do a bunch of tweaking to get it to work correctly. But you install that inside Windows and it will just work straight out of the gate. So these are the things you have to sort of average out. You have to work out, Player Unknown Battlegrounds is a massive game right now and it's not working. So there is a bunch of games that work and a bunch of games that don't work. And some people may think that I'm being a bit harsh and I'm bashing Linux. I'm not bashing Linux whatsoever. I do like Linux and I think Linux does have a place and it is getting better over time. Now remember guys, these are just my opinions. I would like to see what your opinion is in the comments section below. Try and keep it civil. And these are just an opinion about whether Linux will replace Windows. It's not trying to bash Linux at all or trying to blow smoke up Microsoft's back door, because at the end of the day, it's just an operating system and I'm just telling you the way I see it. Now, if you're interested in the market share for Windows against Linux, you can see it here on this chart here. Linux has 1.41%, which is hardly anything compared to Microsoft Windows. It's absolutely huge, the gap, and it beats and crushes all of the other opposition. Now, this video is not about what Windows does bad. We all know the bad sides of Windows 10. This video is about whether Linux will replace Windows, and that's basically it in a nutshell, really. Anyway, I'm going to wrap this one up. I hope this one's been helpful to you. Let me know in the comment section below what you guys think and what your opinions are, and whether you think I'm way off and whether Linux is closer to Windows at replacing it than I'm actually saying it is, or whether I'm completely wrong about the whole thing, or whether you think any other things. Just let me know in the comment section below. I'll be interested to read your comments and I'll try and reply to some of them, and obviously keep it clean, and I'll do my best to see what you guys think. Anyway, that's going to be about it for this video. My name has been Brian from brightechcomputers.co.uk. I shall see you again for another video tomorrow, maybe a less controversial topic than this one or the last 2 days. Anyway, thanks again for watching. Bye for now. Now, if you haven't subscribed yet, hit the red subscribe button and hit the bell notification button and click all to be notified when we upload new videos.